So in my last video, I showed you how you could install the iOS 15 developer beta right now instead of waiting for the public beta. But whatever device you're running the beta on, it may be unstable as it's a beta, and if you feel like downgrading, there isn't any button on iOS to help you downgrade instantly. So in this video, I'll show you guys a way to downgrade to iOS 14 from the developer beta or the public beta without losing your data at all. In case you're watching this video thinking how you could install the developer beta for free, check out this video on my channel for more info on that. So let's go. The first thing you do is make sure your device is at least at 50%, as the process takes a long time. Make sure you have a computer and a lightning cable around with you, and don't forget to take a backup of your device in case something goes wrong in between. Now go to ipsw.me to download the firmware from Apple servers, and as of making this video, the version of iOS that is signed is iOS 14.6. Now make sure you know the model name and the model number of your iOS device. To check about it, go to settings, go to general, and about to check which iPhone or iPad you have currently. So on this website, I have to select what device I have, and I have an iPad right now running the iPadOS 15 developer beta. So I'll select iPad, find my iPad, and download the current signed firmware for my device. Now this would be a huge file, as we are basically reinstalling iOS 14, so give it some time. So after it's done, make sure you have iTunes on your computer, or if you're having a Mac that's running Catalina or later, you can find your device at the tab in Finder. So now connect your device to your computer and open iTunes, and you would see your device pop up on iTunes or Finder. Now select your device and backup if you have already not backed up. And now make sure you have the IPSW file ready. And now press the Shift key if you are on Windows, or the Option key if you are on a Mac, and select Update to manually select a file. Now select the IPSW file and confirm it once. And now it would start the process of downgrading your device. This will take a while and you will not lose your data, but if you want to perform a factory reset, you have to do the same thing as we did for update, but instead of selecting update, you have to select restore to reset and install iOS 14 back again.
A few moments later.
Now after it's done, you would get a confirmation on iTunes and you would see your device on iOS 14. Now open settings, go to general, open profiles, and remove the beta profile for iOS 15 and iPadOS 15 to prevent it from reinstalling the beta once again. And now restart your device. So that wraps it up. Thank you for watching this video. If you felt it helpful, drop a like and comment down your thoughts on iOS 15 and your issues, and don't forget to subscribe for some really good tech videos. This is Sankyo, and I'll see you guys in the very next video. Peace.